Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna alhamdulillahi na'maduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'firuhu wa na'udhu billahi ta'ala min shururi anfusina wa sayyati a'malina man yahdihillahu fala mudillala wa man yudlil fala hadiyala wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله البر الميامين وعلى صحابته المدلفين بالدستور وعلى من استنى سنتهم وانتهج بمنهجهم ولف بلفه إلى يرث الله الأرض ومن عليها وإلى الله عاقبة الأمور. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the entire universe. For all his name and rahmah upon all of us and our households, we can never ever thank him enough. We believe in him as Allah. No one before him, no one after him. Allahu Akbar Kabir. He has exclusively all our provisions and he has never denied any single one of us. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We equally believe in the messengership of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue to show his blessings upon the noble soul of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, members of his household, companions, and the generality of Muslims in the day of recompense. Ameen. Respected elders, brothers and sisters alike, today inshallah Kareem, our sermon is with a topic. Anta wa shahru rajab. Anta wa shahru rajab. Rajab and you. Allahu Akbar Kabira. Rajab is the seventh month in the lunar calendar. As far as Islam is concerned, this lexicographical, when you look at the word Rajab, under Arabic word, it means Rajaba to respect, among other meanings. This happens to be number seven in the calendar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even before the coming of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the pre-Islamic Arab used to give the sanctity to this particular month by refraining from anything atrocity, from anything mayhem, from anything quagmire. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Allah attests to that fact in Surah 2 At-Tawbah, verse 36, wherein he says, Inna idda tashuhuri inda Allah ibna ashara shahra fi kitabillah. Yawma khalaqa samawati wal ard minha arba'atul hurum. ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Allahu Akbar. Allah says, the number of months in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is 12 months, just like we have January to December. Allah done his own before the person who gave back to the person who thought of even giving January to December. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Allah had this 12 in his own calendar. يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضُ. Right from the day he created the heavens and earth, before any human being, Allah had programmed it that we are going to have 12 months in his lunar calendar. Allah says, مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةُ الْحُرُمُ. Of these 12 months, there are four considered to be sacred. Allahu Akbar. The sanctity of these four, Prophet ﷺ exhibited and he played there for us to know what we should do, what we should not do. Allah says, ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ. That is the straight religion. You can never, ever find another religion to be at par with Islam. Allahu Akbar. May Allah not kick any one of us out of Islam. Allah says something which is a point blank to all of us. And that's the point we are going to look at, juxtaposing what Allah says in the Quran with the reality of ours today. Allahu Akbar. Whoever that is doing good knows. Whoever that is doing otherwise knows. And on the day of Qiyamah, Allah said it, وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ. Your Lord can never, he is never going to cheat anybody. The reason why he says, فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't cheat one another. Don't oppress one another. Don't suppress one another. Don't
intimidate one another. Allahu Akbar Kabiru. The same way Allah revealed this in the Quran, he told Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in hadith al-Qudusi. Fima rawaha Rabbi. Allah directed to Prophet sallam, Ya ibadi, all of you my servants, Allahu Akbar Kabiru. Whatsoever you call yourself, you are a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before becoming president, you are a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Leaving presidency, you still remain a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Governors, servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ministers, servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Organizers, servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is proud of every single one of us. Allahu Akbar. May we all end up in Al-Jannah to Firdaus. Allah says, Ya ibadi, all you my servants, inni haramtu dhulma ala nafsi, I have made cheating an abomination for myself. Allahu Akbar. I have made oppression a forbidden act for myself. I have made cheating, intimidation, wrongdoing, Allahu Akbar, an abomination for myself. If I do, no one dare challenge me, but I will never do it. وَجَعَلْتُهُ بَيْنَكُمْ مُحَرَّمًا. I have also made it a forbidden act among yourselves. فَلَا تَظَلَمُوا. Do not oppress one another. فَلَا تَظَلَمُوا. Do not cheat one another, because الظُّلْمُ ظُلُمَاتٌ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. If you cheat somebody on her, and you do not give the person his own right back, Allah for sure, sure banker, Allah will collect it back on the day of Qiyamah back to you. And if the person has wronged so many people, he has cheated so many people, he has oppressed uncountable number of souls, Allah will collect all the good deeds to give to every single one of them on the day of Qiyamah. Because he collected money on her, there shall be no money on the day of Qiyamah. He collected their promotion on her, there won't be any promotion on the day of Qiyamah. The only promotion is on tobacco of Al-Jannah, Allahu Akbar, and tobacco of Nar. La dalka bunna tobacon and tobacin, Allahu Akbar. There are those who have been Al-Jannah, uppermost, and for those to Allah, oh Allah, we are never in any way closer to it in terms of our upper Allah. But your rahmah supersedes that. May Allah extend his rahmah to all of us. There are people who end up in hell, tobacco and tobacco, based on the level of their anomalies, Allahu Akbar, based on the level of their wrongdoings, humiliation, taking people's property, siphoning the treasury, they will bring the money back, but there won't be money. Allah will collect all their acts of ibadah and give back to those they have wronged on her. And when they become empty, nothing again, that's a good act. Allah will collect the bad deeds of those who have been cheated on earth and have up to their own bad deeds. Allahu Akbar. May Allah never do that to all of us. How will Allah not do it? Kun fi Rajab. Allow Rajab to pass through you. And also, you yourself pass through Rajab. If a pagan, even before the coming of Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they respected the month. Because of what they had heard from Zabura, Injil, and every other prayer that have come, because nothing is in the Quran except that other people, other prayers of Allah have come. Only that Allah brought everything as an encyclopedia in the Quran. For that reason, those who did not recognize your Lord, those who did not recognize Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they did not even meet him alive. They respected this month. All in preparation for Ramadan. Because if Ramadan comes, and from the first day to the last day, irrespective of COVID-19 or COVID-23, COVID-1 million, wallahi, that COVID will not be brought on the day of Qiyamah. No, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't hear COVID. And it's not mentioned in the Quran, not in Hadith. If that COVID is what is making to distance yourself from your Lord, by the time Malakul Maut comes, you will forget about COVID-19. Then you expect Rajab to pass through you. Refine your habits. There are certain things you know. Should you die today, will there be peace for you inside your coffin? Should you die? And you can die, I can die. Allah, it doesn't change anything from the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody from among ourselves, among those who are coming from behind us, will die and the entire world will cease to be. No. Allahu Akbar. Even in your area, the dog in your area didn't know that somebody died. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Then ya ayyuhal insan. Why do you tell your Lord? No. Zabi,
One day, you are a gunner. Before that day comes, listen to what the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says, I made cheating, oppression, a forbidden act for my soul. If Allah cheated, you have cheated me. Who can challenge Allah? Nobody. But for you to know, your Lord is a just God, then our leaders are expected to be just leaders. You, between and your wife, you are expected to be a just husband. Business partners, be just, be truthful, be reliable. Let people speak good of you while you are alive. That will tell a guy who tell you what is going to happen when you are buried. But today, should you die, what will happen? Will you be happy? If you die today, and Malakul Maut is showing you, as Allah says in Surah Al-Isra, كل إنسان أنزلناه طائرا في عنقه ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يلقاه منشورا اقرأ كتابا كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. If you sin before you die, just as Allah said, every single person who followed Isa alayhi salam, not as a prophet, but they called him a God, Allah, or Holy Trinity, or 3-in-1, or 4-in-100, before they die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall show them that they have followed the wrong way. And on the day of Qiyamah, Isa, Bahir, Allahu Akbar Kabiru. He will also remove his hand from them. Just like you and I, Prophet is trying. He has tried for us that he wants to make you and I happy and then wants to be proud of all of us. But Shaitan says no. Now, will you choose that of Allah and his Rasul? Or you will be in the state of Fir'aun? Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep all of us upon righteousness. These, don't oppress one another, because there are specialities. Allah wants you to live the spirituality of Rajab for you to get set for Sha'ban, so that by the time Ramadan comes, irrespective of whatever, we say it again and we shall continue to say it. COVID-19 is nothing. Irrespective of COVID-19, you must fast. Because you go out to look for money even with COVID-19. You still press your phone, you go online. You have Twitter handle, Facebook, Allahu Akbar, WhatsApp, everything. COVID-19 does not stop you. Then it must not stop you from observing Ramadan the way you are expected to do. Otherwise, on the day of Qiyamah, Shaitan will tell you and I, that lumu anfusakum. Don't blame me for your travail today. I do not have hand in your sorrow today. Allah called you, I called. You choose to follow my own call and let that of Allah today. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. I cannot even rescue my own self. Talkless of all of you. May Allah not make you and I to be from the camp of Shaitan. Now, this, the spirituality that you are expected to live with in Rajab, number one, because that Rajab, number one, Allah respects it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected Rajab to be from among the four sacred ones. What are those other ones? Dhul-Qidah, Dhul-Hijjah, then the Rajab, Muharram. These are four. As you do all your acts of ibadah, you need to understand why did Allah make it special. Rajab, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rajab hosted the spiritual journey made by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in your own best interest. What was that spiritual journey? Surah Al-Isra. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا. That Rajab hosted that spiritual journey made by Prophet Sallam, ordered by Allah in the company of Jibreel alayhi salam. Allah says, لنريه من آياتنا. Exalted is he, Allah, who has taken his servant to go through a night journey from Masjid al-Haram, a sacred mosque, Masjid Mecca, to Masjid al-Aqsa, Jerusalem, from where he got to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heaven. Allahu Akbar. Allah says, لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا. So that Allah will show him. Allah showed him some of the signs. Part of the signs, Prophet Sallallahu said when he came back, he was given the opportunity to sight hell and those who are already there. May Allah not make you alive from among those who will be there. Why will you not be there? Why must you not be there? You must adhere strictly to the advice given to you by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And not only that, he saw the hell, he saw Al-Jannah, Allahu Akbar, and people who are already, the dwellers of Al-Jannah.
Allah transforded what will happen the day of Qiyamah for Prophet to see it on heart, for him to tell you and I, so that we know that all the acts of ibadah are not in vain. To reassure you, to reassure me, that your Qiyamah lane is not in vain. Your zakat you are paying, you are actually investing in Yawmul Qiyamah. And that investment is huge, not an investment of CBN. It doesn't have any attraction or whatever. You invest that, you get it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you appreciate it the most. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Now, not only that, part of the signs of Allah, Allah should process Allah, Allah gave us Hamsu Salawat. In fact, daily prayers were established during this journey. Now, if you are celebrating a Rajab and you are not praying your Salah, then Rajab will go on his way, you are going your way. Your Hamsu Salawat. Allah gave to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam during Rajab. Then, the first thing Allah will check me on the day of Qiyamah from all the acts of Ibadah is Salah. Not Zakah, not Hajj, not Ramadan, not graduation of Quran, not Lesser Hajj. أول ما يحسب عليه العبد يوم القيامة الصلاة. That is why you need to take that Salah with all respect, with all honor, Allahu Akbar Kabir, without any element of sarcasticity. Don't pray sluggishly. It is your best interest. Allahu Akbar. Kullu mawludin yulad ala fitra. As you are coming to this world, the first thing you cry, that sujood you did for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You go back after your demise, they will still pray over you. If only you pray. May Allah make all of us from among the Muslims. Restaurant brass in Islam. Another thing is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accorded respect to this month. The reason why it says, La tazolamu. Do not oppress one another. Now, this goes from up to down, from down to up. Government to the masses, don't cheat one another. Husband and wife, live in peace and harmony. Don't wrong your wife just because you see you are too bossy. Bossy for what? You are too bossy. And I've done this, I've done that. Clearly, come to the Yawmul Qiyamah. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did better than you. But women will always be women. Then you must respect that aspect in them. Prophet Sallallahu says, "Kulikina min dhirin a'awaj." They are created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from a rib that is not straight, very bent one, rough. The only thing is that you massage it, try to straighten it. If you force it to straight, then you break it. And vice versa. The women are expected to also give their husbands respect. Now, coming, فَلَا تَظَلَّمُ. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't cheat one another. If you do istighfar 1 million times, if you cheat somebody, you will not get istighfar, you will not get maghfirah. You will not get. And that is why we have been shouting on top of our voices. If you are appointed to be a leader, either president, governor, minister, local government chairman, even headmaster, if whoever, it is a trust Allah has given to you. Allah shall query that on the way of Qiyamah. Anything that has to do with the well-being of the citizens, see, today, you live from one state of quagmire to another already existing. What is happening? Kankara students kidnapped. After a while, released. Was there any money ransom paid? No. At the end of the day, someone was arrested. Money was paid. Millions of naira. There was not sunk inside that village for people to enjoy, but it was given to people outside. Now we are talking of another one, Kankara. A village. Look at the classroom. You cannot keep your dog inside the classroom. And there's no federal presence there. Our governors are busy. They can't even ply the road again, and they are not shameful of that. Wallahi la tus'aluna yawmidin 'ani an-na'im. And all of us, in whatever capacity we contribute to all this mess, Allah shall query all of us. Many lives are wasted. The same major, not up to 2 weeks, 20 travelers were kidnapped. Women, pregnant women. Where are we heading? Allahu Akbar Kabiro. It is far better for you and I not to occupy a position of authority than to go there without discharging the responsibilities. Allah will query us on the day of Qiyamah. And people are living lives. We have said this repeatedly and again. But the government itself is not using the stick to correct whatever anomaly. That of Kankara, at the end of the day, a chairman or somebody in the local government was apprehended. We all saw him. He facilitated the kidnapping of those boys. And at the end of the day, he mentioned how much was paid. But the federal government said no money was paid. Who is deceiving whom? kidnapping a very juicy business. You kidnap people, kidnap somewhere, wallahi al-azim. If the kidnappers are not going to do tawbah and leave that, they will regret on the day of Qiyamah. They are coerced. If there is any allergy, who is buying gun and giving to people, wallahi, you regret inside your cobra on the day of Qiyamah. Because all these people are not coming from Niger. We deceive ourselves. How so many come from Niger and not all the lungus in Kagara, local government in a remote area? Then who is giving who an information? Allah will start from the first person. Who is the president? Wallahi al-Azim. Wallahi al-Azim. It's not the truth. It's not the cause. Let's take from Umar ibn Khattab. Always we draw our lesson from him. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. His wife, Atika, says, Kana Umar yabki liyanam fi layl fa yatiru minhu an-nawm. At night, Umar will come, I'll dress the bed, I'll give him food, come and sleep, he will sleep, thinking you are sleeping. Allahu Akbar Kabir, yatiru minhu an-nawm. The sleep will desert, sleep will go away from Umar, he won't be able to close his eyes to sleep. Khalifa to Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, no president can equate himself with those wounds. And we deceive ourselves, especially PAs, TAs, SAs. You are buying houses in Dubai. One day, you and Dubai, you are far. You are going to face this on the day of Qiyamah, starting from your company. The money is meant for ammunition. You send some troops. At the end of the day, these boys are killing them like chicken. The same ammunition used during Shagari regime is still what is there with them. And you come and still appropriate another money for another year. Wallahi la tus'alunna your way then. I'm in Naim, Allah is not joking. Atika was telling the Sahaba, the other wife of the Sahaba, that this is what happened to my husband. Every night, he will come to sleep, he won't be able to sleep. Woyakilis, woyabuki. Umar ibn Khattab will get up from his sleep, he will start crying. Prophet, I have a president, more than even president. Khalifa to Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will be crying. Fa'akul, Atika said, I will tell him, Mada bika ya Amir al-Mu'minin. What is the matter with you? Oh, you, the leader of the Mu'minin. And Umar ibn Khattab, listen carefully. This is for all our leaders. It is not yet Uhuru. Yeah, I would like to contest as a senator, as the House of Rem. It's better for you to be ordinary Al-Haji, who is getting the protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do your own bid and go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without carrying anybody's body. Than to go there and mess up. Because even if you don't want to mess up, the system will mess you up. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Umar will say, Tawallaytu amra ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I took oath that I got this privilege to lead, to pilot the affairs of Ummah Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after the demise of Abu Bakr Siddiq. Wa aksha an yas'alani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yawm al-qiyamah wa fihim miskin, fihim mustada'afin, fihim aytam. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Umar ibn Khattab will say to his wife, from this Ummah I've inherited, there are poor people who are defenseless. There are weak people who are speechless. There are people who are powerless. There are needy, downtrodden. Allahu Akbar Kabir. There are aytam, orphans from among them. Aksha an yas'alani Allahu anhum yawm al-qiyamah. I fear that Allah should ask me about every single one of them on the day of Qiyamah, how will I get past mark? That's why I rise in Islam. As a leader, some of our leaders don't fly the road again, helicopters from here and there. We are in a critical situation. Some of them will still fly abroad to go and watch Arsenal and Real Madrid. La ilaha illa ant. Subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Whereas their children are not the ones, they are not the electorates. Their children don't vote. Have you ever met any child of a governor or president in a polling unit? You don't see them. It is these people that are paying back. See Kankara, see Kankara. What is the presence of federal government there? These are predominantly farmers. Federal government is not sending money to them. Bandits are not sending money to them. The school classrooms are just in shambles. Allahu Akbar. That's the qualification. Nothing to write home about. None of us in this masjid can take our children to that kind of school. And we're all in the same country. La fadla ala al-arab lil-ajam.
وَلَا لِلْعَدَمْ عَلَى الْعَرَبِ إِلَّا بِتَقْوَى.
There's no difference between children of a minister, president, and governors, and children of nobody. There's no difference. Why is no difference? Umar ibn Khattab didn't mention other big wigs from among the women. He mentioned miskins. He mentioned the Aitam, orphans. He mentioned the Aramil. We always tell ourselves, an ordinary camel, Umar will be shedding tears that if this camel died in a child process, Allahu Akbar Kabir, child birth process, and he could not save the camel, what will he tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah? How many people have been killed in this country? Some will kill, they will pay money for others to kill. Just because you want to get to power. Allahu Akbar. Here, dunya. It is just this dunya. Aqallu min al-qalil. Dunya is worthless. Wallahi al-azim. Dunya is worthless. How will you know that it's worthless? Only, Prophet ﷺ says, Raka'ata al-fajr. Khayru min al-dunya wa ma fiha. Raka'ata al-fajr in one night is better than the entire dunya what is there in mundane life. La ilaha illa ant. Subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Let's remember us in Islam. You may not be governor. You may not be a minister. But you are another Muslim. That Muslim you are, make sure you put your own da basamataka, meaning drop your own legacy. Do something to help the Ummah. Allahu Akbar, before it is too late. Write your name in gold through your sadaqah to the less privileged. Try to give to the same community that has given to you. We talk of all these people, from president to the last person, they are living in government houses. Ummah ibn Khattab never lived in any government house. He was still crying. This one, they have sirens. Even the ordinary PA, SATS, the kind of flamboyant life they live. I'm not challenging anybody, but challenge yourself before death will come and challenge you. In the hadith, that girl. فَمَنْ شَاءَ اتَّخَذَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ سَبِيلًا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعِزَّةِ وَالْجَلَالَةِ أَحْمَدُ حَمْدًا يَتَفَرَّدْ بِهِ جَلَالُهُ وَأَشْكُرُهُ شُكْرًا يَتَوَحَّدُ بِهِ جَمَالُهُ وَأُثْنِي عَلَيْهِ ثَنَاءً يَتَصَرَّفْ بِهِ كَمَالُهُ وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صاحب الشفاعة الكبرى والمؤيد بسمع المذاهب والقرآن العظيم صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله أخيار البرية وأصحابه أحرار المزية وكل من عاش على منهجهم إلى قيام الساعة. بارك الله لكم في هذا القرآن العظيم ونفعنا إياكم في الآيات والذكر الحكيم. أقول من تسمع صوابا فمن الله وإن خطأ فمن نفسه ورواية وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين بكل ذنب وخطيئه انه هو غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب للطول لا اله الا هو واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له الاول ليس قبله شيء والاخر ليس بعده شيء والظاهر ليس فوقه شيء والباطن ليس دونه شيء واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله المحمد الحبيب المصطفى المختار صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى اله نجوم الهدى وأصحابه جزور الحجة وكل من سار على منهجهم إلى قيام الساعة وبعد. معاشر المسلمين، إن شهر رجب شهر من الأشهر الحرم الأربعة. عش شهر رجب وحاول أن يشعر ويحيا شهر رجب في حياتك. كن مع الرجب في دينونته ودينونته وديدنته من حيثيات شتى حسب ما جاء به نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ومن فكرة ما جاء في الآية فلا تظلم لا تظلم أحدا لأن الظلم ظلمات يوم القيامة ولا اتق الله حق تقاته في معاشك وفي معاملتك بين أسرتك وفي معاملتك مع أصدقائك وكذلك أصحاب التجار. الله أكبر كبير. إن عشت بالرجل وحاولت أن يعيش الرجل فيك أنت من ضمن الذين يقولون بالصف الواحد مع نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وكن حذرا كن على حذر وادع الوعظ من حياة عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه حتى تكون مسلما صالحا ليس مسلما طالحا وفاسدا. عباد الله إن الله مرت عمر بدا بنفسه وثنى بملائكته حول عرشه وثلث بكم من انس وجن وقال هذا من قائل ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد. عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل ان الله يامر بالعدل ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين واذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر كيد اعداء الدين وانصر عبادك الموحدين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. ولا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العلي العظيم. اللهم اجعل الامن والامان في نيجيريا واجعلها بلدا امنا مطمئنا رخاء زكاء وسائر بلاد المسلمين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم ايد رئيسنا محمد بخاري وانصره نصرا عزيزا وانصره نصرا عزيزا وايد له بطانه صالحه التي تدل على الخير ويقربه ان شاء الله. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان في كل يسر وامن وامان وفي معيشه يسيره وفي حياه طيبه ورزق واسع. اللهم اسكن لدينا الفردوس مع الابرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين مع الذين نتعلم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن اولئك رفيقا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك. قوموا الى صلاتكم رحمكم الله.